So, yeah, you'll find 700,000.
Okay, perfect. Hey everyone, I'm Akash and I lead product at a company called Scapic. Before I get into the company itself, I'd like to sort of ask a few questions. Right? So when was the last time you all purchased a product? There was a recent sale which happened, the big day sale, there was a Flipkart sale, the Amazon sale, multiple sales which are happening, right? And everyone sort of trying to sort of sell you a product. And in general, when we go purchase a product, what do you do right now? How do you purchase a product? What's your general flow? Okay, you read reviews. What else do you do?
We get a picture of that.
Yeah, look at the pictures. What kind of products do you do that with?
Clothes, especially.
Okay.
Accessories.
Even electronics.
Electronics. Has anyone purchased furniture online? Yeah, some of you. So in general, whenever you buy any of these online, right, all they're looking at is pictures. You're trying to see pictures and you're trying to make your buying decision on that, right? So, as Ashwini told us, there are 8 to 9 images right now on like Amazon, which they're allowing you. And you take a look at all these images, one of them is a video, and then you make your purchase based on that. Right? And most of the times, when you get your product, you try to convince yourself that, hey, okay, I'm happy with the product that I bought, even though there are one or two things which you're not happy about. Right? That's a problem. That's a problem that a lot of people are facing right now. And a lot of the times, it leads to returns, as I said, 20% of them. So that's a problem that a lot of companies are facing out there, and they're not able to sort of solve it. They're trying to solve it using different methods. What we are suggesting is a way to improve the shopping experience, improve conversions, and reduce returns using these two technologies called 3D and augmented reality. Right? So by using these two technologies, we're able to allow customers to actually see the product, to actually try out the product way before it had, before they even make the purchase, and they make a actual good buying decision by actually seeing this before it happened. How do I do it? Let me get into the presentation. So if you just take a look at content, right? We've seen how content has evolved over time along with hardware. So if you take a look at how things started, we started with text. As you said, everything was textual back then. And even if you have to buy a toothpaste or anything, everything was textual. You need a blog, it's textual. You need content, it's textual. That's a problem, right? Because again, you need to create this picture in your mind. So that's where things started to evolve a little better. That came in with information 2.0, which is pictures and videos started to come today. Now we're able to sort of grasp this content a little better and take a look at it and sort of understand this content a little better. Now we're heading into the immersive age, where we're dealing with technologies like 360, 3D, VR and AR. Right? These are technologies that come. How many of you have actually tried out VR and AR over here? Oh, interesting. Okay, that, I actually don't see this much of that. So these are the technologies which are going to be coming in the future, right? And these are what certain brands and businesses are trying right now. Along with content being evolving, hardware is also evolved. Currently we're at the smartphone age and we're heading to the immersive age, where all of us will be just wearing glasses like these and then, you know, making all our purchase decisions over there. And what are these technologies? All of you know the difference between VR, AR and MR? Yes? Everyone knows? Cool. Then I'll sort of switch over. In general, people consume VR using these kind of, this sort of different formats. This is a VR headset. And people consume AR using these different formats. So they use headsets, that's what we're heading into. But currently, it's your smartphone which allows you to try out this. And if you generally look at the evolution of the media landscape, the growth of VR and growth of AR has been significant. There are a lot of brands and businesses, e-commerce brands and businesses too, who are using AR and VR right now in different marketing material. Right? They use it for Facebook marketing or Instagram marketing. They create these filters. They create a particular campaign. Right? But not any of them have directly put something on their website or got all out with it over there. Amazon is now enabling AR directly on their platform over there, where they allow you to see the product. But again, it doesn't work across all devices. It's only in the US right now. There are some limitations over there. And if you're talking about AR and VR in general, and how it's going to reach 5 million users by 2022, this is the metric that people are sort of assuming right now, it's not going to happen one app at a time. In general, right now, if you have to consume any of these experiences, if you have to see something on Amazon, you need to have that app. If you need to see something on, probably like the IKEA, you need to have that app to do it. And it's a separate app that you have to install. It's not going to happen one app at a time. And in general, people have to install these apps. There are limited business models, zero experiences, and it's for experts only. So, we are trying to solve this with the web, right? Every single one of you on your device, regardless of it being Android or iOS, you've got a browser on it, which means each and every one of you can easily open up any website on your phone and consume the same experience across all of them. And that's where Scapic makes it easy. We've built a set of DIY tools which helps brands and businesses use you know, like simply drag and drop some of their images. We create a 3D model of their object, and they're easily able to actually view this product in 3D and AR automatically. Right? So it's a simple drag and drop tool. Think of it like PowerPoint, right? You've all used PowerPoint. Think of it like PowerPoint for AR, right? Where you can simply drag and drop images, get started with, and it's a DIY tool. We want to make sure that we give this to the customers and we don't want to handhold them through the entire process. And as I said, it's cost and time effective, no technical expertise required, and cross compatibility across web and AR. It works across both, right? And in general, if companies have to do this right now, they have to invest in a 3D designer. They have to invest in actual developers who know web technologies. They need to invest in a lot of things to initially get this started with. We provide a simple tool that allows them to do that in a very simple manner. And this is one of our products, which is what we allow you to see the product in 3D. So you can easily embed it onto that. You don't even need images. Since you're able to sort of see the product entirely in 3D over there, you can easily take a look at all of its different parts, zoom in, take in all of these details. And the great part about it is we provide you analytics for these, right? Which means you're able to go in and see which part your customer looked at and which part they were interested in. The number of clicks on that particular part. We have another concept called hotspots, where you're able to, whenever you take a look at an e-commerce page, they talk about the size in different parts, they talk about the different features in a different part. We put all of it on the model itself, so you can take a look at the different details in one place. So your customer is spending the most amount of time on your particular product, and they're taking a look at your product in very much detail. And this is something that we're soon going to launch, which is what we call a button embed. We have multiple ways to do it. We have a viewer, which I showed you in the previous one, and we have something called a button embed, where if you see, all you have to do is click on the button on your page. It opens up into this view. You're able to take a look at your product in 3D, and you're even able to click on the View in AR button, and you're able to place it in your space that way. So this is how you can use augmented reality to actually take a look at your product, make people go and actually see that before they even make a purchase. So we primarily deal with companies in the furniture sector, the fashion sector with shoes and bags, and we even deal with companies in the electronic sector, as I showed you, Google Home. And even some, we are sort of venturing into a lot of these brands are D2C right now, and we focus on D2C majorly. Because in general, Amazon and Flipkart and all these different brands have tried this approach, but in general, getting general support across has been a problem for them. So we solve this across every device. It works perfectly fine, regardless of the device that you have. And yeah, that's pretty much our product, which we allow you to sort of see your customer, allow your customer to see your product in 3D and AR, help them with better conversions, and help them help improve the customer experience when they're taking your product. So yeah, that's Scapic. So currently, we have a SaaS-based model, which is you come and sign up to the tool, and we give you a set of SKUs which you can upload onto the platform itself and keep these SKUs maintained. And we have a view-based model where we bill you on the number of views that you get for your particular SKUs. We don't charge you on the number. We, of course, limit you on the number of SKUs, but we can have around 100 SKUs on the platform and still have around 25,000 views across. So we sort of charge you based on the views that you get for your particular products. And it's a monthly charge that these companies and brands have to pay.
It's still everything itself. So yeah. Your business model is that you give access to your kind of platform.
Yeah.
Then we give you SKUs and then you do the 3D modeling and give that file to us back, or how does it work?
So it's directly a link. So everything that you get is a link, and you can easily embed this onto your website. We have Shopify plugins, WooCommerce plugins, which you can easily use to integrate onto your platform if you're a Shopify platform. Otherwise, we give you a link which you can easily embed onto.
Who will make the content? Who will make it, or they are supposed to?
So in general, when we're dealing with certain companies like the automotive sector,
because you also said DIY, so.
Yeah, so in general, when you're dealing with companies in the automotive sector and the furniture sector, they have CAD models with them already, and furniture 3D models with them already. So, yeah.
One information I give you.
Sure.
Though they have all these things, most of these are run by an agency. Mm-hmm. So, this, instead of going to the brand, like for example, I have an agency, I can do it myself. Even a small brand like us, we'll have some small agency. If this is a SaaS model to the agency, and they can use it for any brand what they're serving,
so we are focusing on small businesses right now at the moment, because for them, making sure that they stand out is what matters.
Yes, that could be, but
yeah,
if you catch an agency,
yeah,
you have 10 small people under them, right? 10 or 15.
We are partnering up with some agencies right now. So
what's the typical time frame from, let's say you sign up with this brand?
Yeah.
What would be your time for them to go on?
So in general, if you have a 3D model, we do the conversion in a matter of minutes, where we have a backend algorithm that's...
So we If you have a 3D model.
If you have a 3D model. So
assuming you start with
I have this one, right?
Sure. If you don't have a 3D model and if you're getting started with that.
So what would be the time?
It takes around a day to sort of convert around, let's say, 10 SKUs of yours. And we can get those live. We have a separate model cost depending on the complexity of your model. So that is if you don't have
a 3D model. You want to indicate a range.
Range.
So what would the shoe, for example, cost you?
It depends on the complexity again and the details of the different parts. It would cost you around $50, $50 to $80.
For modeling
cost. Yeah. And if the scale increases, of course, the cost decreases for particular models. But for the entire platform itself, it's a view-based pricing strategy where you keep all these SKUs live, and depending on the views that you get, you're able to sort of go use the platform and keep paying monthly.
And when are you trying to get that model up?
One day.
One.
So I was talking to some of these local retailers who
yes.
are selling clothes online on Flipkart. Or
yeah.
So they said they have stopped selling
yeah.
because every 3 months, 4 months, they get new designs.
Yeah. Yeah.
And we are supposed to kind of get nice pictures of it and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And Amazon itself is asking them to discount it. So do you think that they would be ready to pay this cost on a regular basis for every product that comes new every 3 months?
We don't focus on the one, we don't focus on the clothing sector. Because one, using clothing and clothes in general and fabric in general, it can be replicated. But people don't tend to actually see this and make a purchase of it because there you can feel the texture. And a lot of people, they do it based on materials that you put over there. So you can replicate this, but people would rather not prefer that. So we primarily focus on furniture, electronics, automotive, these sectors.
So what's the typical small, most of your customers are smaller?
Yeah, so we do work with a few enterprises, that is like Royal Enfield, a few companies like Doc Motors, who generally have automotive models.
So what are the typical average onboarding, forget the other side.
For a particular customer?
Yeah.
I mean, currently we are just signing up with certain alpha brands, that is we are reaching out to them and getting them on board. But soon we will be sort of rolling this platform out, and we will be existing as a Shopify plugin on their app. On Shopify, it's on the App Store. So they'll be able to directly integrate this and get started.
You need to understand, no, what's the cost?
What's the onboarding for one? What is the average cost?
So, sitting in front of you.
Yeah, he could potentially be a customer.
You say yes, but I want this webinar on money. What is the cost?
It depends on the models, number of SKUs, and the complexity 14. That you have. So 14, it would be times around $30. So that will be the initial cost for you to model these. And to keep them live, you get a 1 month free trial. After which you pay a fee of around $30 per month.
Yeah, if you sign up 5% of each ticket, right? If you sign up 5 years,
you sign up. But yeah, so. SKUs and views. Views is majorly what we price on.
And how do you price for view? What is
it? I mean, it's totally you get 25,000 views so for $30.
Impressions.
Impressions and yeah, mainly impressions and of course the number of SKUs you keep up because if the public and we do progressive loading of the 3D model.
Sure. I'm trying to make two complex pricing models, like one you charge for the model, then the hosting, and then your impression.
So it's only the case if
it's like I'm paying the photographer who clicked my photo, and because after that photo I got married, and because of that,
and you have paid for everything, and you might still not have sold.
Yes, I understand. So over there, that only comes in the case where you don't have 3D models to get started with. A majority of what you're focusing right on the
model.
It's
fine, right? I mean, yeah. I don't have a photo, that's right. Yeah. I'm not asking to print my photos, right?
Yeah.
So the modeling is done.
Yeah.
And once it is done, then why we have to?
It's a one-time charge. So the
I got that. That is fine.
Yeah.
But why we have to pay on impressions?
Because one, every time we sort of get a view over there, we are incurring the cost one on loading the 3D model progressively, and we're handling all the
That is the hosting charges, right?
Yeah. It's not just hosting. So we make sure
it's not even hosted on you. It's hosted on Shopify or wherever they're.
Not really. So the 3D models that we have, we are like YouTube. So just like how when you're watching,
hosted here and then just
So just like how on YouTube, you progressively load a video, you see 360
pictures. Charge videos. Only for hosting, right? Flat fee. That's how
so
directly transferring the cost.
So in general, we are trying to automate the modeling cost, right? Which is there are ways for you to take these images. There are methodologies for photogrammetry which are used to take these. Exactly. So we are automating this entire thing on the cloud. So currently, some parts are manual, and that's why the initial modeling cost exists. But we will be eliminating this entirely once we automate the entire process. So
is the bandwidth ready? Like for example, a beautiful photograph where you can go and zoom it to 20 30x, 30x. Yeah. It's fine. And you put this 3D model and you get going on, I want to
do that. Not at all. So that's where I say progress is anyway. Where we, just like how you load a YouTube video, right? You load it in 360 plus if your connection is bad, and then we progressively enhance it. So you get a model, you're never hindered the experience, and if you place it in AR, it's the same model and it progressively renders over there.
Basically, what's the headset video is like a 360 view, right? Pardon? The headset you have shown here is 360 view, right?
This one?
Yeah.
This is a 3D view, yes.
360
view. 360, yes. You can see all sides of it up, down, bottom, left.
Can you see what like this Reliance view wants to do? It's a hologram with the...
Yes. Yeah. So that's the MR.
So with the same AI with hologram, it's
so that is something called mixed reality. That's mixed reality. That's a different technology.
No, but that is also that is coming in TV. That is integrated with the 5G. Because that becomes much better experience.
Not entirely. Actually, with Reliance Jio, it's a little bit of a hack that they've done. They bought these devices from China and they're just reselling it over here. It's not actually a good headset. So in general, good
headset. Suppose I want to buy this.
Yeah.
It integrates the hologram, it shows my picture.
Okay,
with the SART and see.
You see in the TV. So, try-ons currently are allowed on our platform. We allow try-ons in certain, we are working with certain eyewear brands for that. But try-ons are currently limited to certain latest iPhone devices. It's not there across all the devices. So, we have not enabled it across all of them. So, it's only for a particular sector of people. So, we have not enabled try-ons for people. So we can actually
try.
What I showed you here was augmented reality. So we are able to click on that.
But the problem with that is you need to have that app on your phone, right?
No apps. That's where we come in and we do it entirely.
True?
Yeah. So that's no apps installed.
What is your ask here?
Here I'm currently coming to sort of bring in a set of users, early onboarding users who we are sort of getting into the platform. We want to make sure that we at least get a set of 500 partners. In the beginning, just 100 partners to start with, but 500 user base where we can sort of filter and work with them, manually onboard all these people, speak to them, understand their feedback, which currently the product is right to go out, but we want to make sure that their feedback shapes the product itself.
I think a good presentation. Maybe that was your ask. Mm-hmm. I think you should ideally talk about what it takes for a brand to be on board.
It just takes images. All you need to start with
is We have to ask you so much.
So there are certain competitors in the US right now at the moment, but currently their major focus is just viewing your product in augmented reality. We take that two steps or three steps forward, where we provide you conversions, where you're able to sort of actually put in your email ID, we allow you lead generation. We provide you multiple methods along with that to see it, but the major thing is viewing it in 3D and AR, which generally on a lot of
people. I think your agenda was to get that.
Yeah.
And you should talk about what does it take to onboard.
I get it.
And I think you wasted a lot of time talking about showing all that AR, VR, and it's all good story maybe 25 years ago. But talk about what does it take for
sure.
And to cost time and also in terms of that analytics that you provide and dashboard.
Yes.
This is what and how this could further help you.
Correct.
Right? Okay. Those are the things you should focus on. Because I think what is useful for what you're looking at, your pitch did not work.
What are the themes, how old you are, some importance as an image.
Sure.
Normally here that's what we look for.
Since you're not looking for money, that's okay. But
the
thing
you're talking about, how do you measure it and give it feedback and then makes you a
customer? So every time, my presentation gone. But when you sort of open up that button, what we showed you, what opens up, right? We have these lead generation options over there. You are able to sort of click on buy now. When you click on the buy now button over there, we sort of redirect you to the PDP. We have a cookie that's tracking all of this that your business can take and compare the data with. And we are tracking all of this on our analytics dashboard on the platform.
No. That is basically a sales pitch. They are not directly affecting your business.
Exactly.
Thank you so much.
Sure.
Good one.